Let me show you a dedicated AI health platform. It's an AI health assistant that's going to help you give you diagnosis of what you might potentially have. We're going to provide it with the information, and it's going to provide us with a potential diagnosis that we might have. Plus, we can also generate a report, and we can also use this generated report to get a second doctor opinion with their service. Now, this one is called Docus, and I'm going to show it to you right now. This health service that I'm talking about is called Docus, and if you want to check it out, link will be provided in the description. And yes, they do have a free forever plan. Now, you can use this with the data that you know already, like I know my age, I know my height, I know my weight, etc., and let it know what my problem is. But I found out that this is extremely useful when you have some laboratory tests. So that means that if you have some blood tests, some sugar tests, etc., and you input that data, you won't believe how accurate this can be. Now, let me show you how it works. Now, once you sign in, you're going to go into your AI assistant, and this is where you're going to get started. This is the AI health assistant, and I'm going to start a new chat, okay? Now, I already got some nutrition food that I'm going to start on, so this is pretty cool. Okay, so first of all, we want to tell it our basic information. When you go to a doctor, you know they're always going to ask you some basic information. Your age, your sex, gender, your height, your weight, etc. We need to provide this information to get the most accurate health diagnosis, okay? So let me type in my information. So I am 39 years old, and I'm 175 centimeters tall, and I weigh 83 kilograms, which is not ideal. I'm overweight. And let me tell it what my problem is. So let me think about something that could be potentially interesting. Okay, so here we go. I'm starting off with this question where I have some lower back pain in the mornings and they are really extreme. And these are most present in the morning. So I'm going to start off with this and we're going to let this tell us what we might have or if it has other doubts like it's asking us right now. So in this case, it's asking us 5 questions, obviously, to get a better diagnosis. So not based on your first chat is going to be the result. So it's asking us this. Can you describe the nature of this pain? Is it sharp, dull, shooting, or radiant? Does the pain improve or worsen with movement on certain positions, etc.? So let me go ahead and answer this and let's get started. So number one, and I'm going to respond to this. Okay, so I just finished responding this and what I just said is sharp pain, it worsens. And number 3, it's numbness, no recent injuries. And 5, I have diabetes, which I don't, but we're just trying to make this interesting, okay? Now, these are the probabilities of things that I have, and it's based on percentages of how probable that is, which is pretty neat that it provides that. So let's send this information out and see what diagnosis is going to give us, okay? So based on what we provided. All right, so we just got the results, and this is the information that we got. Thank you for the additional information. And here's the updated list of possible causes, okay? So again, we got it based on percentages, what we might have, and based on most probable to less probable. So it could be a lumbar radiculopathy. I hope that's how you say it. Musculoskeletal strain or sprain. Diabetic neuropathy. Degenerative disc disease or other, okay? And here are the future evaluation conditions they recommend. This AI health assistant recommends. So for example, it's recommending a physical examination to evaluate blood tests, imaging tests, x-rays, MRIs, nerve conduction studies, and so on and so forth. So in this case, let's just say I'm interested on the blood test, but it didn't tell us exactly what we should check. So let's ask it what type of blood test it recommends. So let's see. All right, so I've just asked it, what blood test should we test for? And let's see what it provides us. Okay, so we just got the results for this, and these are the blood tests that it recommends us to do. Now, this is pretty interesting because if we go to a physical doctor, this will save us time because if we already know some previous symptoms that we might have and we come with all the blood tests ready, well, they're going to give us a diagnosis that's going to be quicker. So, for example, it's asking us to do a complete blood count. I won't say the names, but this is what it's recommending. It's pretty cool that we get all of this. Now, you can keep on asking this. You can even ask us for nutrition health recipes for the week to help us reduce the blood sugar based on a low calorie count, based on a Mexican style food, etc. And it will provide us for us, which is pretty cool. Now, once you have all these diagnoses and you're satisfied with the information that you've got, you have the option to generate a report, okay? And this report is going to be really neat because if you want to use this for a second opinion, it's going to be really great that you provide this beforehand. Now, let me show you one of the examples of a history and report. So this is the history of an AI health assistant helping us. So here's the user. This is the issue that it had. You'll see the chat that was going on. Now, based on that chat, we generated a report. And this report was done on this date. This is what it's for. The patient information, the medical history, the symptoms, the instructional examination, laboratory examination, differential diagnosis, clinical pain plan, and treatment plan. Now, this was a short chat. If you have a long chat with all the data that you provided, you're going to get an even better history report that you can provide to a doctor to get a second opinion. Now, you can go to a physical doctor, or you can also use a service on Docus that they have. You can do a consultation right here, okay? So you go to consultation, you can choose from the top doctors that they have. You can see, choose a doctor from 300 top doctors chosen, preferred consultation type, written or video, communication health conditions, and receive medical second opinion. This service is also provided by Docus for an additional fee, but they have it available. So in your account, you have the option to do all this health assistant information on chat history, on the health assistant. You have your chat history where you can go back to these histories that you've ran. So here's some tests that I've ran. I've ran one personal one for me, which is why am I losing hair, right? So I wanted to know if there was some tests that I can run to kind of discard some things. So if it's a DNA thing, or is it something that I have on my scalp? So it's recommending a scalp biopsy, dermocopy, and some blood tests like that. So I can view my previous histories and check them out. And obviously, we have our generated reports. So in this case, I have the report. It's still working. This is another report that I am running because I want this report to get a second opinion. So it's pretty cool that we have all of this with Docus AI. And like I mentioned before, they do have a free forever plan that you can use. It's a bit limited, but it's useful, okay? And if you want to jump into the paid plan, it's well worth it to get all these health opinions. And this might even be great for doctors because basically this is an updated database that's going to give us really quick diagnosis of what a patient might have. So several reasons why you might want to use Docus for personal or for professional reasons. But there you go. That is Docus. I do recommend that you check out the link in the description and jump into that free account to test it out for yourself. And that's a wrap.